COVID-positive disability support staff are being forced to care for patients while infectious. The special exemption's been slammed as dangerous, but the state government says it had no other choice. Reid Butler has today's developments.
COVID positive, but still working with our most vulnerable.
It is incredibly concerning that this decision has been made.
Three disability support staff from care provider Possibility granted an exemption despite being infectious.
You do have complex relationships between the carers and the patient. Where you can't just switch people in and out at a whim.
The six residents in their care at the Stall residential facility are also positive.
It seems to be implemented very quickly with little to no consultation with the union, and we believe little or no consultation with the service providers.
The government hasn't ruled out granting similar exemptions in the future as staff shortages continue to cripple the health sector. Across the state, case numbers have dipped, Victoria recording just over 13,500 new infections, but 35 deaths have been reported, and that's the highest number during the Delta and Omicron outbreaks.
It is again a sombre milestone that we should all reflect upon and highlights again the importance of all the work that we're doing as a community.
And what better example of that work than this? A walk-in blitz for kids at the Frankston Community Vaccination Hub.
It has been a busy day, definitely.
VR goggles on hand to help distract from the nerves.
I heard that some people can get reactions, but not many people.
As the vaccination rate steadily climbs, hospital numbers remain stable. Just over 1,000 Victorians are being treated. Melbourne also beginning to look more like its former self.
If you've noticed it getting a little busier out and about, you're right. It appears our self-imposed lockdown may be over. New research from the University of Melbourne suggests population movement is now back around 70% of pre-pandemic levels.
Compare that to earlier this month when population movement was only 10% higher than stage 4 lockdown. Reid Butler, 9 News.